Hi everyone, I'm Harshvardhan, an artificial intelligence engineer, and you're watching another WebGuide YouTube channel. And today we are going to work on an Amazon price tracker. So here we will use web scraping to scrape the data from Amazon website and check whether the price of a particular product is less than a particular price or not. So let's get started. And if you have not yet subscribed, hit the subscribe button and also hit the notification bell icon so you don't miss any of our upcoming videos. So let's begin with importing beautiful soup and request and URL open from urllib. So we will say from bs4 import beautiful soup as bs, and we'll also say from urllib dot request import request and url open right here. And now we need a link to the product, so let's jump to the Amazon website. So here in the search bar, I'll search for a laptop. And I'll select this very first one, and its price is $46,999. And if the price of this product is less than $40,000, I'll like to take some action like sending an email or any other action. So we need to scrape this price. At first, we need this link. I'll just copy that, go here, and as a string, I will paste that link. Now I will say HTML is equals to URL open, and which URL we need to open? This link, and we'll get an error. So let's wait for it. Yes, here we got saying HTTP error 503, service unavailable, because we are not sending any user agent. So for this, what we will do, we will say header is equals to a dictionary, and in the dictionary we will pass user agent, and in user agent we will say Chrome, and here as a request we will say request, and we will create a request for link, and the header, I think it is header or headers, it's headers, and here we will pass headers. Now we have created our request, so we need to open our request. So we'll say req right here, and we got an error saying that set object has no attribute items. And why this has happened? It is happening from right here. So we have made a mistake here, because it should be like this and not on the cell. So we succeeded, and here check for html.code, and it's 200, right? So let's create the object of that HTML. So we will say object is equals to bs, and we'll pass HTML, and wait for it. It's done. Great. So let's jump to that website and use Control Shift I to open developer tool and clear this out, and use this select an element in the page to inspect it, or Control Shift C option to inspect this price. And here you can see that it is a span tag with ID of price block our price. I'll just copy this ID, and now here I will say object dot find. And what we need to find? We need to find the attribute, and that attribute is a ID. So we'll say ATTRS, or attribute is equals to a dictionary, and in the dictionary I will say ID is equals to the copied ID. Let's run the cell, and you can see that we got that span tag where there is the price. So I'll just say dot text. And you can see that we got rupees, and then space and then the price. So I will just say scrape it from to end. So we got the price of that product, and we don't want the amount after this period. So we will just say dot split, and where we need to split at period. So we got the price with 46,999, and I'll just select the first one or zeroth index. Great. And now we need to replace the comma with the empty string. So I'll just say like this, and here run the cell, and you can see that we got the output of 46,999. So save that to price is equals to this, and I should put them inside int, and I'll just say price right here. So now our price is an integer price, and it is 46,999. That means we can easily perform any operation over this. Now I'll say if price is less than 40,000, then print it's time to buy the product, and I'll just say price is equals to the price, and I will say the link. So I'll say link is here. Let's run the cell. You see that there is no output because the price is 46,999 and it's not less than 40,000. I'll just say greater than to check whether our code is working or not. Now I have a task for you guys. What you need to do, you need to check whether the price is less than 40,000 or not, and if yes, then you need to integrate the send email project with this project. So if the price is less than 40,000, your script should send an email to your email, and it will say that the price is now less than 40,000, and this is the current price, and this is the direct link to the product. And after completing the project, I need you guys to post that how you have implemented that project to another WebGuy Facebook page. So this is the link to another WebGuy Facebook page, and I should put in markdown, and let's go to this page. So here you will just paste the code that you have implemented. So that's all for this lecture. See you in the next one.